Whether there's a sustainable future for artists really depends on what happens at this critical point now. So I would say that we've never needed art more than we do now. We do need artists and musicians in our community, and it's going to be hard though to find the resources to pay those artists and musicians, because typically artists and musicians have not been valued properly. It's always been hard for artists and musicians to get a proper, you know, wage, let's face it, or a fee. And people have always expected us as artists, and I'm an artist myself, to somehow work for free because we love what we do. And it's the case that we have to make a living. So I would suggest that maybe there's a place where we can utilise artists and musicians to bring together the community more. And in those communities, families, tribes, we start to support one another. And I think that musicians and artists can be a catalyst for this to occur. But we need to find a way to remunerate artists and musicians in some way so that they can also have a sustainable life going forwards. And I don't think we've really found a way for that to occur yet. I think as artists you have to think of yourself as a business and you have to market yourself, and I know that that's foreign to us as artists. You know, we want people to just discover our talents and book us and the phone to ring, and the reality is, you know, that's just doesn't happen very often. I mean, yeah, you know, if you're a Kylie Minogue or a Delta Goodrum, but even they have worked incredibly hard to build their brands, and they have built brands, and you have to see yourself as a brand. And you have to market yourself as a brand. You have to get out there with your social media, your Facebook, your Instagram, your LinkedIn, your Twitter and so on. And you have to share video clips of your work, your CDs, your artworks and so on. And you do have to be prepared to do a lot of work for free to start building and developing an audience for yourself. I know that that is not realistic for a lot of artists, and they feel like, well, I always have to charge a fee, and sometimes, you know, that will deter someone from engaging you, and you have to find a balance between charging a fee and doing some things for free. You have to see every opportunity where you meet someone as an opportunity to market what you do. So if you're sitting on the tram next to someone, and I've marketed people in the tram in the ladies' bathrooms, you know, look, I'm known for being opportunistic and finding leads. You know, read a magazine and see what events are coming up and approach the organiser of those events and see if your services might be needed in the future. Look at where other performers are getting gigs and approach those people presenting those gigs. Work with other musicians and artists to collaborate as groups, to put all your services forward as a group rather than just as a solo performer. I've had a group for 30 years. We're celebrating our 30th anniversary this year, Potpourri, and we've had an incredible career, really. We've performed in over 40 countries around the world. We've released 7 CDs. It hasn't always been easy. We haven't always had enough work. It's come and it's gone. And you have to ride the hills and valleys of a professional artist's life. It's never going to be consistent. So join us at Creative Innovation 2017 Asia Pacific, Human Intelligence 2.0, Thriving in the Age of Acceleration. This conference takes place 13th to 15th of November at the Sofitel Melbourne on Collins. We're bringing together 40 of the leading innovators, futurists, entrepreneurs from around the world to talk about this rapidly changing world. Artificial intelligence, robotics, drones, autonomous vehicles, the future of work, how we can prepare and manage for this rapidly accelerating world.